My name is Daniel Tamago and I'm graduating from college this semester with a business major from the National University of Singapore. Though I honestly can't wait to finally graduate from the traditional educational system that has held me hostage for the past 20 years of my life, graduating means one thing: I am officially a working adult. And all of a sudden, the weight of the world now falls upon my shoulders. I'm running out of time to chase my dreams. Alright, that was quite a dramatic introduction, but good morning guys. Okay, so right now I'm here in campus because I have class in a bit, but I'm over here right now at my secret spot to do my usual morning vlog and just chat a bit with you guys. So I get a lot of comments from you guys pretty often asking how I'm always so disciplined and motivated all of the time. So if you guys follow MBTI, I am an intuitive. I'm a very big picture kind of person, always trying to find like the deeper meanings in life and always thinking about the future, kind of like Doctor Strange. And I've said this a lot of times on my vlogs before that I have really big dreams and goals in life, and the only way that I can slowly inch closer to these goals is if I stay disciplined and motivated on a day-to-day and week-to-week basis, slowly crushing mini goals every day that leads to me crushing even bigger goals in the future. So the first step is to find your dreams in life, and the second is to work your ass off to get there. Without a goal, you can't score, and likewise, without a dream, it's honestly really hard to find the motivation. So this constant struggle of like achieving my dreams has led to me pursuing a lot of different side hustles while being a college student here at NUS. So my friends and I, we run a video production studio here in Singapore that you guys will see later on in the vlog. And aside from that, I'm also pursuing content creation here on YouTube as well. And officially of today, I'm releasing my own clothing brand that will be live by the end of this video. So yeah, this video is kind of dedicated to showing you guys what a day in my life looks like of me chasing my dreams. And later on in the video, I'll also be sharing some tips on like the steps I took personally to figure out what my dreams were, as well as how I use that to keep me motivated all of the time. Alright, but anyways, before that, I have a class to attend right now, so let's go.
Riding my ride in my Batmobile, hit it, beat, stop. I got that rocket, I'm making them deal. Hit it, beat, drop. Drilling the bitches, my body go weak. Yeah, riding my fast machine. Yeah.
What's happening? I'm dead.
Right, so this guy left class halfway. What's he doing?
Yeah, I'm focusing, bro.
You're focusing. So we just got done with class. So this class is called Entrepreneurial Finance. It was pretty interesting. The class was actually split into two different groups. So three groups were like entrepreneurial groups and the other three groups were like investor groups. So I volunteered to be the entrepreneurial group, of course, and we just had quite a fun time doing like startup pitches and raising investments, like funding rounds. So yeah, that was pretty fun. Okay, so right now I'm actually heading over to Yale NUS U-Town. So this is actually the first time I'm visiting after 4 years of being in NUS, so I'm pretty excited about it. So long story short, I actually did like a protein giveaway at the end of my recent body transformation video. And by the way, you guys can use my promo code Tamago for 52% off all products on the My Protein website. So one of the winners actually told me that he lives in Yale NUS, which is in U-Town, which is my favorite place ever in NUS. And since I'm in school today, I thought why not just pop by for a visit. So let's go. We are what them young boys feel. Somebody asked like, what is the difference in the lifestyle between like Yale NUS and like NUS?
Yale NUS College is 1,000 students. It's a fully residential college. NUS is 32,000 students plus plus. It's a liberal arts college. We don't actually focus on any one single discipline. Mm-hmm. At our second year, we get to choose our major. There are many, many majors on offer. I'll say the biggest difference is that because of this, we are allowed to have a lot of...
It's like a college tour, right?
Yeah, we have a lot of academic freedom. You know, we don't have to be in the School of Social Sciences. Classes in social science.
You have a lot of choices,
right? Yes, exactly.
Choices. In terms of like student life,
yeah, it's very, very happening because it's a small school, so pretty much everyone knows each other. So, yeah.
Had a good tour.
Bye bye.
All the best. Ciao.
Bye.
What's up?
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, man.
Hello. Are you from Yale?
From RC4.
Okay, bye bye.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Okay, so right now I'm heading back to the office. Got a couple of meetings and shoots later, and I got a tutorial as well. So yeah, that was a really good tour. Let's go. Right, so I just got back to the office. I actually have a client meeting in like 10 minutes time, so I'm pretty late. And right after the meeting, we actually have a shoot in our studio. Food Locker actually got Chris and I to be the talents for their upcoming Chinese New Year campaign launch. So another production house is coming to our studio to shoot the photos and videos for the campaign. So yeah, we're going up right now. Let's go. Let's go down in the deep. I just got back home. I hope you guys enjoyed joining me for a day in my life of me chasing my dreams. By now, if you haven't realized, my dream has got everything to do with content creation and trying to turn my passion into what I do for a living. It has always been like this for the past 6 years of my life. So yeah, this is kind of what every day looks like for me as a college student. Okay, so I'm sure you guys are waiting for updates on the clothing brand and the merch. So here's a quick backstory of the entire brand. Okay, so I found this book, Daniel Tamago Merchandise Clothing Brand, and I did this like almost 6 years ago in 2015, and it has always been my dream to start my own clothing brand. So the name of my clothing line is called MAGO brand, and if you're curious, MAGO stands for the last four letters of Tamago, and this is because in 2015 my friends used to call me MAGO, and that is why I decided to name the brand after that. The reason why I named it that was because I really wanted a brand that represented myself, to create products that symbolize all of my values in life and items that really reminded myself of my dreams and to keep pushing me on and motivating me, and at the same time also being a source of inspiration for others along the way. Thousands of designs later, there was one design that really stood out among the rest, but I'm gonna leave that for a future project because it's still work in progress. So for now, my brand logo is my signature. This is inspired by one of my biggest YouTube inspirations, Peter McKinnon. Okay, so over here I got one of his rings. So the story behind this ring is that he got one of these on the day that he decided to make the life-changing switch to turn his passion for photography into his career. So likewise for me, the day that I bought this ring was also the very day that I decided to go all in and pursue my passion of turning content creation into my full-time job. So the interesting thing is that I wasn't always this driven and passionate about life. It kind of was like a slow and evolving process that started around the time that I enlisted for army for my national service in 2015. So back then I was going through a very rough phase in my life. I was partying a lot, like full attendance Wednesdays, Fridays, Saturdays, and I threw a lot of house parties as well, did all sorts of stupid shit as a finally legal teenage adult. So by the end of 2015, I told myself, okay, screw this. I was really unhappy with where I was in life, and I knew I had to do something in order to make things change. I can remember the last week of 2015 very vividly because that was the turning point for me. So I was literally so lost and aimless in life. I spent the entire week just sitting there reflecting and meditating about my life. It suddenly occurred to me that, okay, maybe I should just pen my thoughts down, the different years and stages of my life, and maybe like write down what were my accomplishments in life. So I started writing down like, okay, this year I was in primary school, this year I was in junior college, and by the end of the exercise, I realized one major flaw of my life was that I never had goals. And frankly speaking, I couldn't even blame myself because my whole life, I never had the time to dream. Prior to army, my whole life was just dedicated to studying and studying and studying and school and O-levels, A-levels. There was nothing else outstanding aside from the fact that I knew how to study decently well. Okay, it's kind of different for everyone, but back then I realized that the biggest thing I was lacking in my life was having dreams to chase. Okay, so back then I was already a couple months in after buying my first camera, the 700D with the kit lens on. So I just decided to tell myself, okay, let's try pursuing photography and videography. And there was just something about creating content that exploded my creativity and gave me so much fulfillment in life. Like, I can't even explain the feeling of satisfaction in words. So fast forward a few years later, we are now running Parallax Collective together, as you guys saw earlier in the vlogs. And yeah, we are definitely gonna try to continue sending it for the rest of our lives. Okay, so if you guys remember the title of this video, the one thing that motivates me like crazy is time, because time is running out for me and I'm still not where I wanna be yet. Most of my friends are already in the process of securing full-time jobs with really good companies. So honestly, I feel like I've taken quite a big risk to pursue content creation and entrepreneurship, as the income streams are much more volatile, and especially because the market is so shaky right now. Yeah, but personally for me, I feel that some things like what I'm pursuing right now, it really takes a lot of time. And it's best to start when you are younger, when the weight of the world hasn't pinned you down yet, when you don't have to worry about bills, saving up to buy a house, or having your wedding in the future, and subsequently having kids. I always strive to live a life of no regrets, but sometimes it is scary to think of the countless hours I've wasted mindlessly scrolling social media and just sometimes just lying around aimlessly when I could have really been spending that precious time working on chasing my dreams. Because honestly, how I wish I had more time right now. Money comes and goes, opportunities comes and goes, luck comes and goes, but time, once time is gone, you never get it back. So I created Project YOYO, which stands for You're Only Young Once, to serve as a huge reminder to myself. This year, 2021, is the year where I finally graduate, transition from a young person to a working adult, and there's a small window left for me to chase my dreams, and I don't want to waste a single second of it. For all my younger viewers out there watching this, I hope this has inspired you, and perhaps let this serve as a reminder to you as well that life is short and you're only young once. Chase your dreams.